Good afternoon. This is a session for the BBA Aviation Management Semester 4th student on the subject Aviation Legal Environment Necessary Link with the Permanent Passport. For the commencement of this session, lecture have been notified, and now I am waiting for the student to join this session. Good afternoon, Yogesh. Let me wait for your other friends so that we can commence today's session. So we have to little bit wait.
Good afternoon, sir. Okay, sir.
So today is the last lecture because the target has been given, the deadline for the completion
no,
of.
Sir.
This course completion has to be completed in this week only, so it will be your last lecture, and we almost covered the all units. So today I am going to end this semester, and if this IMS faculty permit me, then only revision class will be there. Otherwise today I will complete the course as far as this subject is concerned. Today unit number 5 I am completing this course, and probably they are this IMS management is planning your examination for senior batches semester 4 and semester 6. So this week we have to complete our course. And today is our last class in this week. So anyway, we have completed our target to complete the course today. So as far as unit number 5 is concerned, as per the syllable only these 2-3 convention was mentioned in respect of international convention. This is the last unit which pertains to international convention, and 3 major convention was only mentioned in subtopic of your syllable. However, in interest of yours, I have also included the few more convention, and yesterday we other convention we yesterday we covered all that. All balance convention with you. So today is the last lecture, and we are trying to complete our course in this regard. And as far as the syllables is concerned, this last unit is for international convention, and 3 convention were there which we already covered. Today I like to introduce you the some important terminology when we talk about the international scenario. Some important terminologies always been used in respect of aviation and legal terminology. So today what we like to do, we'll try to do the understand the various terminologies, and it will be helpful to you for future preparation and future. And these are the small things which needs clear understanding, because when we talk about any international scenario, any international legal implication, the various terminology used in your reference material must be very very clear to you. So today we'll start this last session of unit number 5 with the use of various terminology, understanding of various terminology. This will be the topic of discussion today, and then our course as far as the syllables is concerned, today I am completing our course, and if the permission is given by the management of IMS, then we'll try to cover the revision part. Otherwise, I am skipped, because today my 36th lecture is there. And normally, I keep one lecture each for revision. And due to this target of completion of scheduled studies in this week, I am skipping the revision portion, because every unit a standard lesson plan is there. That every unit I have planned 8 lectures and one lecture each I kept for the revision. And now due to paucity of time, 36 lecture I am completing your course. So let me take one attendance, then we'll continue discussion on various terminologies which is used in legal perspective of aviation. So this will be the important aspect for your understanding point of view, and it will help you to understand the entire subject. Many times you may come across many terms and during our course of discussion. So let today understand the, what are these terminologies. So we'll begin with the very first treaty, and this term treaty is very, very important. And as you know that being a member country of ICAO, India is also a member nation. And what we do many bilateral treaty. Bilateral treaty means bilateral means two states, whenever they come together and formally concluded a relationship in the form of agreement. And between two states, it is so, this is called bilateral treaty. So what is treaty? Treaty is a formally concluded and ratified agreement between two states. Any states or multi-state or two. So treaty may be bilateral, multilateral. So what is happening in treaty? When the member country come together and agreed on certain principles, certain rules, and whatever they ratify, means they agreed and signed together, is nothing but given the shape of treaty. So this is a treaty, and the term treaty is used generally to refer to instrument binding at international law concluded between international entity, states or organization. Even the on the behalf of government of India, many times the representative bodies like DGCA, like Airports Authority of India, when the government of India authorize them, or many times trade organization, they are also authorized by government of India to execute treaty. So this is a general term, and legal document is developed when, and as per the international law, it is concluded between the entity, it may be state or may be organization. And the 1960 Vienna Convention defined treaty as per the Vienna Convention, definition of treaty is an international agreement concluded between state in written form and governed by international law. So the main thing is it is governed by the international law, whether embodied in a single instrument or in two or more related instrument and whatever is particular designation. So treaty is nothing but a written statement between and signed by single or multi or two states or entity, and in written form comprising of annexures, so many things it can be comprising, and it is considered, and when the both states or everybody has signed, it will be the legally binding, and it should have legal legal agreement in terms of international law. And the essentialities of treaty must be a binding instrument, which means that contracting party intended to create legal rights and duty, because legal rights are there as well as duties also there for every state or every organization concluded by the states or international organization with treaty making power governed by the international law or should be in writing. So these are the essentialities of the treaty. So this is nothing but a treaty. It is known as treaty. And types, as I already told you, it is known as bilateral treaties when they concluded between two states. And similarly, European Union also makes so many treaties, and it is called European Union treaties. Similarly, our SAR country treaties. So economic development. So all such names are there, but it is basically bilateral, multilateral treaties are there. Multilateral treaties I already explained. And similarly, one more treaty is there, universal treaty. It is concluded amongst all countries, like ex-union charters or whatever the agreement signed at UN, all the member country, it takes the shape of universal treaty. And it is again in written form, is all essentials and all form, all the part of international form. And it is a contractual. Basically, there are the responsibility, there are the binding on each state. So this is nothing but a treaty. So this is a very wide term used in aviation. So I like to discuss today what is treaty. Next is convention. Convention, our last chapter was the international convention. So what is basically convention? We have understood that it can have both a generic and specific. Convention can be held for a specific subject, and convention can hold on general subject. So it can be specific, it can be general. And Article 38(1) of Statute of International Court of Justice refer to international convention, whether general or particular, a source of law. Convention is nothing but a source of law. Yesterday I talked about that, how this legal aviation environment is created. So it starts with the convention. When the member countries meet at ICAO or whether it at the United Nations, wherever they meet, and they agreed on legally, agreed on certain specific subject or general subject. And once they agreed and they signed it, it becomes the international convention, and it's international convention, and that convention has to be abided in the term, letter and spirit, and if needed, respective country has to amend their domestic law in order to comply that international convention, provision of international convention. So that therefore, many times, this flow of legal environment in respect of aviation flow from ICAO. Whenever the convention held, international convention, six convention we already discussed in this unit. And what happened when the origin was the Chicago Convention. Chicago Convention, the Bible and freedom of air, seven freedom of air we studied. And this freedom of air, this Chicago Convention is very foundation for the creation of aviation law all over the world. And thereafter, this all, wherever we go to the convention, what we happen when we agreed for certain universal, international aviation rules, regulation, or agreed for on specifically or general subject, what we happen, we come to India and we go to the parliament and we amend our this aircraft act, aircraft rule, and again aircraft act and aircraft rule empower the DGCA, Government of India, to make certain rules or standard procedure, technical circular. So in this way, no need to go to the parliament even. Then what we convert convention, whatever we agreed in convention, in the form of CAR, civil aviation requirement. So how this flow of legal environment is flowing from convention to our CAR. Lastly, we come to the CAR, civil aviation requirement. And this is the last part of our flow of first act is there, then many times we make rules. So basically the foundation of aviation is Aircraft Act 1934, Aircraft Rule 1937, and these two pillars of Indian aviation. And this Indian aviation two pillars again empower Government of India or DGCA. This is passed by the parliament, and after the assent of Governor, our President of India, this empower DGCA to make rules in the form of civil aviation requirement. And therefore, how this flowing convention to rule, act, rule, then it is civil aviation requirement. So like this, it is entire flow of this convention this convention is a beginning for the international scenario to flow the source of law. It is considered a source of law. It's a secondary source, judicial decision, secondary source in local land of laws are there. And again, teachings are most highly qualified publication, the journey use of term convention embrace all international agreement in same way as thus generic terms treaty. So treaty and convention are generic terms, and when the member country agreed for specific or certain specific or general rules, regulation in respect of aviation, it becomes the rule for respective country, and they have to amend their respective laws, rules, or civil aviation requirement to meet the obligation, international obligation, when they agreed in treaties or when they agreed in convention. So this is a very, very important, two terms are very, very important, treaties and convention. So, and secondary source of judicial decision, most in India, many times the court of law is also applicable, and many times situation arises. So this is also considered, judicial decision is also considered secondary source of law. So this convention, I hope we understand, And usually the instrument negotiated under the auspices of international organization are entitled convention. Example, Convention on Biological Diversity of 1992, United Nations, Convention of Law on Sea. So convention, Vienna Convention, Law of Treaties for 1969, similarly, or by Organ and International Organization, 1915. So many, not even ICAO, UN, United Nations, all whatever the conventions are held, they are the primary source of law for the respective country. So United Nations, ICAO, and these are the international body where in terms of international laws, specific or general convention and treaty held, and that becomes the law, source of law for all the member country. Third thing is a protocol. Third term we widely use in aviation is protocol. What is protocol? Protocol is used for agreement. It is also an agreement, like treaty, like convention. It is also agreement, but less formal than entitled treaty or convention. It is almost informal agreement. All are agreement, but protocol is an informal one. And protocol of signature is instruments subsidiary to treaty. Many times you see the protocols name, ICAO also issue the protocols. So when the convention or treaty is held, and in order to supplement them, the protocol is also issued and drawn by the same party, such as protocol deals with ancillary matters such as the interpretation of particular clause of the treaty, and those formal clause not inserted in the treaty or regulation of technical matters. So ratification of treaty will normally is de facto involved ratification such protocol. So protocol is issued. Protocol is a supplementary to the treaty, and if certain clarification is needed, so again the protocol again issued by the member countries, when again they meet and discuss the particular clause of treaties, convention, and any clarification is required, they issue up the in the form of protocol. So it is supplementary to treaties. So this is considered supplementary to treaties, and the protocol based on framework treaty and instrument with a specific substantive obligation that implement the general objective of previous framework or umbrella convention. So whatever the previous convention treaties was held, so it is a framework to implement certain provision of that clauses more specifically, and it is again agreed by the all member. The example is 1987 Montreal Protocol on substances that depleted ozone layer, adopted for the basis of Article 2, Article 8 of 1985 Vienna Convention for the protection of ozone layer. So this Montreal Protocol again, it is again issued for the supplement. These protocols are supplementing to the treaties and convention. So this is the general third term protocol. So first convention, then treaty, then protocol. These are all this is the sequence in which the legal aviation flow from top to bottom. Then come to one more term is there, that is called modus vivendi. Modus vivendi is, what is this modus vivendi? This modus vivendi is means mode, way, or vivendi means living. So way of living. So together, way of living implies modus vivendi and accommodation between disputing party to allow life to go on. So modus vivendi, it is usually described normal and temporary arrangement in political affair. It is in a political modus vivendi is the term used. And for example, where two sides reach a modus vivendi regarding dispute of territory, dispute of political, historical, or cultural incompatibilities, and accommodate their respective differences is stabilized for the sake of contingency. So in event of contingency, wherever the political or territorial disputes are there, so and consensus and modus vivendi type of diplomatic instrument is used, and it is a diplomatically, it is an instrument recording an international agreement of temporary or provisional nature intended to replace by arrangement of more permanent and declared charters. So it is usually made in informal way and never require ratification. No ratification is required from respective country or respective parliament, and it is a temporary measure to resolve certain issue temporarily. Later it is it takes the legal shape, but whenever some emergent situation is there, contingencies are there, so this modulus vivendi is signed. It is again an agreement signed by the two parties to resolve certain issues temporarily, informally. So this is a modus vivendi. Next, declaration. Next term we use, widely used, declaration. What is declaration? So term declaration is used for various international instruments. However, declaration are not always legally binding. The term is often deliberately chosen to indicate that party do not intended to create a binding obligation, but merely want to declare certain aspirations. So like Rio declaration. So declaration is nothing but in the parties come together, though it is also a written declaration, not an agreement. It is not an agreement or joint statement. Or joint declaration is issued by the two countries for future aspiration. Future we will like to do that, we like to go like that. This will be our path of action. This will be our course of action. So these are all such declaration. It may be bilateral, it may be multilateral. Like the Rio Declaration 1992 is a multilateral declaration on particular subject. When particular group or countries sit together and agreed on certain course of action for resolving certain issues, and give and as an aspiration they declare that we'll try to do this, we try to achieve this, like we try to limit our ozone emission, carbon footprint, like that. So these are the declaration and have no legal binding to the signatories, and it is just a statement, not an agreement. So it is called declaration, and declaration can, however, also be treaties in generic sense, intended to binding an international law. It is therefore necessary to establish in each individual case whether the party is intended to create a binding obligation. Otherwise, declaration will be simply, it can be become a treaty when it is having the legal shape. So there are the, and declaration can be treaty in a proper sense. Significant example is joint declaration between the United Kingdom and China on the question of Hong Kong of 84. So many times it becomes the shape of treaty when it is legally accepted by the signatory as a legal binding. Then come normal term agreement. So we use this, the term agreement. So term agreement have a generic and specific meaning. It is also acquire a special meaning in the law of regional economic integration. Like in 1969, Vienna Convention or Law of Treaties employ the term international agreement and its broader sense. So again, when it is a international agreement, it is a legally binding. Similarly, Article 3 states that it should not be in written form. Such oral agreement may be rare, and they can have the same binding force as treaty depending upon the intention of the party. An example for oral agreement might be promise made by the Minister of Foreign Affairs of one state to counterpart of another. So agreements may be written, agreements may be oral, it may be binding, it may be specific, it may be general. So specific meaning less formal and deal with narrow range of subject matter than treaty. It employs specifically for instrument of technical or administrative charter, which are signed by the representative of government department, but not subject to ratification. Again, it not be ratified by the respective countries. It may be agreement may be between two departments, in internal department, international department, two organizations, and typical agreement deals with the matter of economic, cultural, scientific, and technical cooperation. So it is agreements are general nature or specific nature. And agreement are also frequently deal with financial matter, such avoidance of double taxation, investment guarantee, or financial assistance, the UN and other international organizations regularly conclude agreement with the host country to international conference or to session of representative organ organization commodity agreement. So again, it is a universal term and these agreements held at international level also, local levels also, and it is especially the took the shape of legal binding if the members are agreed on like to give the international shape and agreement. Mostly bilateral agreement is a famous form of international agreement in which the both the country agreed for the certain terms and on various matter, law, social, economical, political, and again it is a legal binding on the both the country. Then charters. The charters is used for particularly formal and solemn instrument. Charters are also agreement basically, and the constituted treaty on international organ. So charter, the term itself has emotive content that goes back to the Magna Carta 1215, well known recent example of Charter of United Nations 1945 and Charter of Organization of American States of 1952. So this is term used for particularly formal and solemn instrument. It is also an instrument like agreement, and it is constituent of treaty. When we do the treaty, its parts are called charters. So this is the one. This is the we can say article, we can say schedule. Similarly, charters are there, and charters are the we can say constituents of treaties. When the treaties are there, they form the charters. So it is a part of treaties, and it is also having the legal sense, and it is also having the it become the part of treaty, and it is a clauses. We can say it is clauses of treaty. So this is a term charter. Then one more term, very common term, it is memorandum of understanding, MOU. It is very common term, MOU. So this MOU is again, it is a very common term. It is also, this is an instrument used at international level, domestic level, between two organizations, between government organization, non-government organization, but this is a term widely originated from United Nations international level, and memorandum of understanding is international instrument of a less formal kind. It is not like agreement. It is a memorandum of understanding and having the less formal kind, and it often sets out operational arrangement under a framework international agreement. It also used for the regulation of technical or detailed matter. It is typically in the form of single instrument and does not require ratification. Again, it does not require ratification. They are entered into either by states or international organizations. The United Nations usually conclude memorandum of understanding MOU with member states in order to organize its peacekeeping or operation or to arrange UN conferences. And the United Nations also conclude memorandum of understanding on cooperation with international organizations. So this is the international term widely used by the under the umbrella of United Nations, where application of this type of term MOU, you might be seen a wide application. Even our Ministry of Civil Aviation signed a memorandum MOU with Airports Authority of India, with various department, government department, public sector department, who are responsible towards the parliament. AAI, Airports Authority of India, is responsible for the parliament because it is constituted by Act of Parliament. And what is happening? Whatever the ministry set the target to the particular government undertaking, it becomes a mayor. And the target is set and agreed by the department, and ministry is also given the shape of memorandum understanding. So similarly, what happened many times, our SAGE University is also signed MOU with other international university for the exchange of student, exchange of courses, exchange of syllables. So what this, so they are also become the legal instruments, and MOU also widely applicable in respect of academics, in respect of industries, in respect of Chamber of Commerce, many times Government of India also signed MOU with the government department, between two government departments, they also signed MOU. Like airports, recently yesterday newspaper, you might seen that Airports Authority of India, Ministry of Civil Aviation, not the Airport Authority of India, Ministry of Civil Aviation signed a MOU with the Ministry of Shipping for the development of this seaports, or you can say seaports or river ports. So they have signed, two departments of Government of India signed MOU to develop this type of activity. So this is a very, this is also international term, it is also domestic term, widely used in the as a legal instrument. Then come to resolution. What is resolution? A resolution is a written motion. Basically, it is a written motion adopted by deliberating body. And the substance of resolution can be anything that can normally be proposed as a motion for long or important motion, though it is often better to have them written so out discussion, it easier so that it can be distributed outside the body after it adoption. And where this resolution is taken? Resolution is taken in any government body, any non-governmental body, any international body. Whatever happened, when the members or the shareholders, like in company, resolution is passed by the so and so company. What is happening in general body meetings in any organization, international, domestic, any organization, when the general body meeting is held and the members agreed on for particular proposal, what they do? They pass the resolution. Resolution means a proposal and proposal or line of action in a particular organization. Even it is also resolution in UN resolution, it is also ICAO resolution. So these terms are widely used. So resolution is nothing but a written motion adopted by a body particular, deliberated by the particular body on a specific subject. And when it is passed, it may be non-binding resolution, it may be substantive procedure. So there are the, this is nothing but a line of action to implement certain proposal in any sort of organization. So resolution is a nothing but a proposal, and when it is normally held in general body meeting of particular organization. So it is may be binding, it may not be binding, it may be subordinate to or procedure. The apply to essential legal principle and rules of right, analogous to substantive law. So having the legal implication, and now and many time it not binding, it is many time it is binding, and it is a legal term used mostly in international level, United Nations level. These all resolution or United Nations Security Council resolution. So all these international resolutions having the legal implication, and every member country has to abide this resolution. So this is about the resolution. So this was the last term I like to discuss with you. And whatever the terms I have discussed with you today is all the form of legal binding, legal resolution, we can say legal part of our whole legal entire system of legality in respect of aviation. It flow from the international convention, treaties. So all like that, it is all flowing in the, when we various terms we use in this aviation legal environment. So I like to introduce you with these terminologies, and I have selected important term with you, and all having the legal implication, all is the source of law or the rules which is followed by the member country. So this was my aim to introduce you this international terminology used in aviation legal environment, in particular aviation legal environment, in particular United Nations framework. So with these words, I like to conclude today this entire our subject of aviation legal environment. We have still 5 minutes with you. If you have any point of discussion you like, any clarification you like, I am available for the 1 or 2 minutes, and we'll continue. Thereafter, I will propose to conclude today's session. Even and if no instruction received, then it will be our last lecture with you. So very best, and thank you very much to join me today as well as in entire session of aviation legal environment. Till now, we have completed 36 lectures and try to complete your course in the way in which you can get the necessary practical input of aviation legal environment. So if you have any doubt, any clarification you want, I'm available for 1 or 2 more minutes. So you can ask me, and I will give you the best wishes for your this MCQ type 100 number question is a part of your end semester examination. And once again, I am advising you, this is a legal paper, so no subjective question will be there. So every law, every rule, you must remember the date of promulgation, date of assent by the president, such type of, and how many clauses are there, how many articles are there. So likewise, you prepare your handouts and prepare your end semester examination, so you can give the, you can attempt a good score in your examination. So my best wishes to all of you for your end semester examination. And if you don't have any question in your mind, then I will thank you, and I will conclude today's session and session of.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much.
Sir, thank you.